No, he took this, and he's not even almost studying electricity, engineering, anything. So I did not expect him to do well. He did struggle with it, but he did way better than I thought he would. So he went through this. I'm just skipping ahead to his work. Without looking back at the paragraph, write down the above the first thing you know you will study. And that is the correct answer. So he didn't get that correct. You'll test terms, spelling test terms, define terms, Ohm's law, define Ohm's law. After studying it, Ohm's law states that the current through a conductor between two points is directly proportional to the voltage and to Wikipedia. Marcus had actually broke his right hand at the beginning of kindergarten and then his pinky at the beginning of first grade. So for the first 2 years he had to learn how to use his left arm. And I love the fact that he sourced cited Wikipedia. Ohm's law. There are only two things that you have to work with. Voltage, variable, current, I and E, amps, resistance, R, and O ohms. When you know one of these two, you can do the other. Ohm's law is easy to separate the pi. Question number one. Write an equation for Ohm's law. E times I equals R. C piece of A. E stands for volts. I stands for currents. And resistance. Let's see how Ohm's law of the pi is used in voltage and currents and resistance. So, the question is, the resistance can be counted as we know, and the answer is volts and amps, which is 'Cause I forgot I hadn't done that. Now the own pi is the solution real problem. So draw the pi here to just give that a handy, which is correct. Create three examples of Ohm's law and prove your work. I will make a nice note. He's better at math than me. I need a calculator, which I don't have readily available. He does his math in his head. If we know that the heater question, so 220 He wrote 220 R. His math is 220 over 0.1 amps, 2.20 volts, 220 resistance. Okay. So ohms. We didn't go over this, so I believe he solved for amps. This, I'm not even gonna, I don't give him half credit, we were reworked this problem, because he didn't even almost begin to study any of this. I'm not gonna give him half credit for that, because this was not his problem. Another way to look at voltage, current, and resistance, voltage, force, he wrote volts. That is incorrect. It is resistance. For not studying any of this, he's doing phenomenal. Oh, we went back, we went over this together. So that is correct. Because he had a question about what it meant, because he's never studied series. And I never crossed out that when I gave it to him, so he was totally confused what it was talking about. So, I'm just going to circle this to remind him. Okay, so I told him to take the path of least resistance, which is absolutely what he did. I didn't explain this to him, so I'm just gonna outline this to show him what it is that we have to do, so that I can go back and explain this to him, and we can work this out in person. And I'm just gonna do it differently so that he knows which way I'm actually talking about.